normally when a person goes to church, like those who are here for the first time, you might be wondering.
Porque quando se vai numa
igreja, when you go to a church,
há um comportamento,
there's a ritual, there's a behavior, a standard behavior of reverence to that moment, to that environment,
aquele ambiente. Mas eu não creio que Deus,
but I don't believe that God has called us.
E ele não o chamou,
and he hasn't called us simply to be here saying, oh God, hallelujah, thanks be to you. I don't believe so. I don't believe so. I don't believe God has called us to be just one more believer in the multitude.
Eu não creio.
I don't believe it. I believe God has called us to set free, to set free the captive ones, to make known his works in the midst of the suffering ones.
Eu creio que Deus nos chamou.
I believe God has called us. That's why he has given us his spirit for us to be indignant
contra toda
at any form of injustice.
Jesus disse,
Jesus said, blessed are those who are hungry and thirsty for justice.
Então, essa fé,
so that faith is what makes a difference before God.
Essa fé agressiva,
that aggressive faith, which has no composure,
que não tem
which is rude,
essa fé bruta, é que
that
faz
rude faith
da pessoa vitoriosa.
It's what makes a person to be victorious.
Porque se você não,
because if you don't manifest this aggressive faith,
você vai ser mais
you will be just one more religious person out there
que se acomoda,
who get complacent before the circumstances and are waiting for God, waiting for God, waiting, waiting and waiting. Life is going by, the days are passing quickly, the years as well, and that person is growing older and waiting that one day God will respond to their prayers. That's not how it works. Let's see now. Whenever I am revolted, indignant, I remember Abraham. I search in Abraham an example. I search in Abraham the way he took possession of what he wanted, his dream. He had followed God for many years, almost 25 years.
E a promessa que Deus,
and the promise God had made 25 years ago hadn't yet been fulfilled. That's the reality. Let's observe. Let's read together. Genesis chapter 15. Let's see Abraham's boldness.
Se você,
pay attention.
Presta atenção que eu vou dizer.
Pay attention to what I'm going to say.
Quisermos,
if we want to live, conquer,
e avançar,
advance,
e tomar posse,
and take possession of God's promises,
Deus, nós temos que ter,
we have to find in the Bible
as pessoas que foram
the people who were referential. Referential of a faith that pleases God. Because one thing is to come and say, I believe in God. That's one thing. But another thing, completely different, is to take possession of what God has promised through your bravery, your boldness, not arrogance.
Mas uma fé
but a true faith,
uma fé,
a well-defined faith,
em que você manifesta,
which you manifest before God without any fear of losing something, because we have nothing to lose. It's either yes or no. Either God works or he doesn't. Either he exists or not. That's the reality. There's no blah, blah, blah. Either God is or he is not. Either he exists or not. Either Jesus is alive or he is dead. How can we know he is alive? How can we know he is the true God? He is alive and ready to attend to our needs. Just when we make proofs with him.
Se não houver uma
if we don't show an aggressive,
incisive, impetuosa,
audacious,
arrojada,
impetuous faith,
não vai acontecer.
Nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to happen.
Escute,
listen to me. Nothing is going to happen.
Não vai acontecer.
Nothing is going to happen with you.
Não é.
It isn't a matter of merits.
Deus não
God doesn't see our merits.
Mas o que
but what pleases him is our faith, our certainty, our conviction.
Você tem que manifestar.
You have to have such qualities within you.
Si.
Então, so here in the chapter 15,
fala assim,
it says,
olha só,
after these things, which things?
Que acontecimentos
which things
que
is the Bible referring to?
Os acontecimentos foram
this is what happened.
O
Abraham's nephew,
Abraão,
Lot,
se
got separated from Abraham
e foi morar
and went to Sodom.
E o que que
what happened? Five kings gathered or rather four kings gathered against five kings and among them was the king of Sodom. And they advanced against those cities and took everything away. People, their belongings, everything. The spoils, everything. So four kings gathered and overcame five kings, made them their slaves, and went away. Among the captives was Abraham's nephew, Lot. So what did Abraham do? Abraham gathered 318 men who were born in his house. 318 men, the best ones, they were born in his house, which means the ones who were born of God. When a person was born of God, he has quality. But when he isn't born of God, he has no quality. He might be faithful, good, nice, but if he wasn't born of God, he has no quality. So he gathered those 318 men and went after those four kings who had overcome five kings, five nations. In other words, Abraham left his house to fight against nine kings. Yes or no? Theoretically, that's what happened. Four of them overcame five. If you put them together, we have nine kings, nine nations, nine empires. So he left his house and he went to rescue his nephew and overcame all of them, took the spoils, took back his nephew. So after Abraham's victory, while all the people were celebrating, Abraham was quite scared, fearful with that victory. He was scared because his fame would certainly spread around those lands and cause all his enemies. He had many enemies because he was a blessed man. The enemies could gather and come against him. So he was afraid. That was a victory that brought fear within Abraham. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Uma vitória.
A victory that generated fear.
Então, depois desses acontecimentos,
so after these things,
de Deus,
the word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision.
Numa visão,
God spoke with Abraham in a vision,
não temas,
saying, do not fear, Abraham.
Quer dizer, Deus,
God came with a word of comfort,
conforto, de
security.
Não temas,
He said, do not fear, Abraham.
Eu sou o teu
I am
escudo.
Your shield.
E teu galardão
your exceedingly
será
what?
Sobremodo
great
grande.
Reward.
Olha só a expressão.
Let's observe this expression here.
Bíblia,
there are certain words in the Bible
rápido,
that if you just read it quickly, you don't understand its greatness.
Assim,
try to figure out. God said, your exceedingly great reward.
Eu
I ask you, does God need to say exceedingly great reward? If God is so great, so powerful, the Almighty God, the creator of heavens and earth, if he had said your reward will be great, it would be wonderful already. But when he says your exceedingly great reward, he is reinforcing the idea of his greatness, trying to pass on to the people the greatness of what he's talking about. Likewise, what Jesus said, the devil came to kill, steal, and destroy, but I came to bring life and life more abundantly. I mean, he didn't need to say life and life more abundantly. He could just say life. For whatever God gives us is good, excellent, great, wonderful, powerful. It's from God. God is the Lord, the Supreme One. And because of that, everything he does is great, glorious. That's the reality. It's mega, super. Anyway, you name it.
Tamanha grandeza. Mas aí
he
Deus
says,
fala,
do not be afraid,
não temas,
Abraham,
Abraham, porque eu sou
I am your shield,
teu
your exceedingly great reward.
Abraão deveria falar assim,
Abraham should say, Lord, thank you, and bow down, saying, I give you thanks. Who am I? I'm a miserable person, a sinner. None of that. Abraham's answer, Abraham's boldness, Abraham's faith, the faith that I receive in this biblical text tells me much more than that. Instead of thanking God for being there, speaking with him, he said, Lord God, observe this, pay attention. Lord God, what will you give me, seeing I go childless, and the heir of my house is Eliezer of Damascus? In other words, what is the point of receiving all these promises from you? You are saying you are with me, you are my shield, and my reward will be exceedingly great. But what is the point of having all of that if I go childless and my heir is a servant of mine? Have you ever thought about that? Think about that. Reason. Use your capacity of reasoning. Let's put aside our emotions. Let's observe this text. This word, this strong word, this strong answer of Abraham to God. Observe it. Who knows if God appeared to you in a vision and said the same thing to you? What would you do? You are full of problems. difficult situations, facing hell, what would you do? Would you bow down and say, oh Lord, thank you. Oh my God, I'm a sinner, I'm a miserable person. That's what you would do? Or you would say, oh Lord, what is the point of having all of that if my situation is a chaos? In reality, I've been facing hell right now. I mean, for a person to have such reaction, Abraham had to be sure of the faith he had. Yes or no? He had to be certain of what he believed in. So, wait, Lord. Abraham complained. Abraham was bold. At least he was bold. Who would speak like that with God? Who would have such boldness to speak with God like this? The author of life, the creator of all things.
Mas é como um filho, uma filha.
But it's like a child that comes to the parents
e reclama
and claims his or her rights.
Reclama
claims his rights as a child. Who would have such boldness, courage?
Você está entendendo?
Do you understand now the kind of faith that pleases God? Did you get the Spirit?
Será que você pega o Espírito?
I don't know if you got
it. Será que você entendeu o Espírito da coisa?
Oh, my Jesus, bless me, bless me. No. It doesn't work, my friend. It doesn't work. Theoretically, it's beautiful. But in a practical way, it doesn't work. When a person is imbued with his rights, which was Abraham's case, he's not afraid. He has nothing to lose. Therefore, he has the boldness to claim his or her rights. Amen? Do you understand what I'm saying? Yes or no?
A mesma coisa se passou.
The same thing happened with Gideon. The same thing happened with Gideon.
Quando o anjo, ele estava trabalhando,
he was working, and the angel came to him saying, Almighty man of valor. He said, no. If the Lord is with us, because the angel said, the Lord is with you. But Gideon replied, if the Lord is with me, why these sufferings came on us? Why we are facing so many disgraces? Whenever we plant, in the time we have to reap, the enemies come and devastate everything. We have to run and hide ourselves inside caves. That's very strong. Please open your Bible. It's worth talking about him too. Judges. In the book of Judges, chapter 6. You're going to see that. See the boldness, the courage of Gideon. Chapter 6.
E no versículo.
And verse 11.
Diz assim, então.
It says, now the angel of the Lord came and sat under the terebinth tree, which was in Ophrah,
que pertencia a Joash,
which belonged to Joash, the Abirite, while his son Gideon threshed wheat in the winepress. Winepress wasn't the proper place to thresh wheat. The wheat had to be threshed on a hill, a high place. When the wheat was thrown, the wind would blow and separate the chaff from the wheat.
Ele estava malhando o trigo.
He was threshing wheat at the place where people used to step on grapes.
Um lugar onde era a mais private reservado. Place. Quer dizer, ele estava trabalhando.
I mean, he was working at the wrong place because of the circumstance.
Por conta da situação, ele tinha que
he had to hide from the enemies.
Estava malhando o trigo no lugar para o pôr a sal.
In order to hide it from the Midianites. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, the Lord is with you, you mighty man of valor. What did he answer? Repeat it, please. Oh, my Lord. Read it, please. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, calm down. If the Lord is with us, why then has all this happened to us? See his boldness. That's an excellent class of faith for you, for all of us. For you to know how to deal with your personal problems. God is not a magician. He will not perform magic in your life. God is not a magician.
As coisas que ele prometeu,
things
as
promises,
promessas,
his
promises, estão disponíveis para aqueles que têm
to those who have courage,
ousadia,
boldness,
para
to
reclamar,
claim,
reivindicar,
to claim them by
no
faith
Senhor
in the Lord Jesus.
Você tem a fé no
if
Senhor
you have
Jesus,
faith in the Lord Jesus,
então você tem direito
then you must have all God promised.
Mas eu
Bishop, but I don't deserve. But who deserves?
Quem é que está aqui que merece?
Who deserves anything from God?
Por isso que nós usamos o nome
de Jesus.
That's
why we use the name of
Jesus. Por isso a nossa fé está em Jesus.
That's why
quando
our faith is in Jesus.
Nossa fé em
when
Jesus,
we rely our faith
nós
in Jesus,
a ter
we start to have the merits of Jesus in us
de Deus,
to go before God and claim our rights.
É por isso que a gente tem
that's why we insist and tell you to give your life to Jesus.
É por isso que a gente tem falado,
that's why we have been leading you to an intelligent faith.
Inteligente, uma fé na pessoa
faith
do Senhor Jesus,
in the Lord Jesus. Because through Jesus, you have right. You don't need the pastor, bishop, to go before God. You don't need Bishop Macedo to go before God and claim your rights. But you need the Lord Jesus. If you don't have him, then it's very bad. It's going to be difficult. But if you have him, it's going to explode. It's going to explode.
Não é questão de religião, minha amiga.
It's not a matter of religion, my friend.
Não é questão de religião.
It's not a matter of religion. It's a matter of faith. Faith is what takes possession of what God promised.
Da mesma forma como ele prometeu a terra,
the same way
a terra prometida para
the land to
os hebreus, e eles, os hebreus tiveram que avançar pelo
throughout
deserto
the desert,
e tomar posse,
take possession.
Eles tiveram que tomar posse
they had
da terra prometida.
They had
eles
to
tiveram
take
que conquistar,
they had
eles
to conquer
que lutar,
they
eles
had to
sacrificar,
fight,
eles sacrifice. Tiveram que manifestar
they
a
had
convicção,
to manifest
a confiança
their confidence
no Deus
in
que eles
God
criam.
Believed.
Porque muitos deles morreram para tomar posse
to take possession
da terra
of the promised land.
Mas
but they fought
e foram avante e finalmente
and eventually
posse.
They took possession
assim
of the land.
São as promessas
and
de Deus.
So are the promises
de
of God.
Não
God's promises
do céu
don't fall from heaven because you come to church.
As
God's promises
não vão cair
will not fall
vida,
on your life,
não vão
will not come on you
vida,
because you simply come
aí.
To church.
Não.
No. But because you learn to use your faith. That's what we are leading people to do. You have to learn to use your faith. And you have to conquer your promised land. You have to do your part.
Se por acaso as minhas mãos abençoassem,
if by chance
posto,
my
posto
prayer
cabeça,
of laying on of hands
você,
made you a
criatura,
new creature,
eu
I would not preach the gospel anymore. I would
aqui,
sit down just laying hands on people's heads.
Mas não acontece.
But it doesn't work like that. It's not a magic.
As pessoas querem facilities.
Oh, bispo, ora por bishop, mim, pray for me there. They put a prayer request there. Wait that we solve their problems. It's not going to happen. You have to do your part. You have to dirt your hands. You have to dirt your knees. Put your face on the floor. You have to manifest your faith. If you don't manifest it, you won't get anything. Even if you deserve it, let's suppose
é uma pessoa that you are a good person, generous, caridosa, uma cheerful, pessoa bacana,
nice,
justa.
Just. But if you don't manifest your faith, an aggressive faith, you're going to be behind. You won't receive anything. Let's say that you deserve it. You won't receive anything. But the other person that doesn't deserve is a thief, perverse, bad person, unrighteous. He doesn't deserve anything. But if he manifests his faith, he receives. And you stay behind. That's how it works. That's how it works. Religion or religions have been teaching people the following. You have to be good, you have to deserve, you have to do this, you have to do that. Yes or no? Each one of them says something different. Yes or no? Just to make people complacent, just to make people have a passive faith, a faith that accepts anything
a tudo na sua vida.
An accommodated faith.
Não funciona. Não funciona.
It doesn't work.
Não funciona.
It doesn't work.
Peraí, ou o senhor existe,
wait there.
Ou o senhor
either you exist
ou
or not.
É, ou o senhor não é.
Either you are or you are not. How can I know that you exist? I can just know you exist when you manifest yourself in my life or not.
Não adianta.
It's no use to see your manifestation in other people's lives, in the pastor's life, bishop's life. Or whoever, I want to see your manifestation in my life. In my life. I want to know. I want to know you. Is that what you want? Is that what you want? Are you sure of that? Are you willing to come to the altar and tell God, oh Lord, it's all or nothing, life or death. Either you give me life or you kill me. Are you willing to do that? Are you willing to say to God, Lord, I have nothing to lose? For if I have to live the way I am now, I prefer to die. If you are that kind of person who says, I don't know what to do with my life anymore, I prefer to die. And you are thinking about suicide. So you are an excellent candidate to know the living God that we are talking about. One thing is what you see in the Bible. Another thing is what we see in our lives. And God promises to make a difference. There must be a difference in your life. There must be a difference in your life. No matter your social condition or racial condition, no matter your condition, your situation, no matter who you are or what you did, what makes you take possession of God's promises is to come before Him and say, Lord, here's my life. It's all or nothing. It's make or break. This blah, blah, blah doesn't work. I want results. I want to see your manifestation in my life. Are you willing to do that? Are you willing to do that? It's war, my friends. It's war. Our war is against hell, the evil spirits that have been working in this world. Spirits of defeat, spirits of failures, infirmities, of division, separation, spirits of hell that are disgracing people's lives. And if we want to fight against these evil spirits, we have to use the living faith in the living God. That's a reality.